Howdy everybody, how's it going? Today I'm actually racing the sun, trying to get to a specific location before sunset. That's not far from where I'm currently camping at Homolovi State Park in Northeast Arizona. Where I'm actually going is called the Little Pena Desert County Park. Sounds like it's a somewhat abandoned park that's in a state of disrepair, but apparently it's got amazing views of the Painted Desert, and apparently not many people know about it, and the sunset's supposed to be spectacular. So that's what I'm trying to do, is to get over there to see if all this stuff is true. So let's go find out if we can pull this one off. Okay, so Google Maps says that I'm about 5 minutes away from the location. I had to take my sunglasses off. Starting to get a little bit dark because the sun's behind the clouds, and yeah, I'm sunburnt. If you haven't noticed, I wore sunblock all day long, reapplied it. I was doing a lot of hiking at the Petrified Forest, and that did not seem to help. So I need to increase the SPF factor, I think, or something next time, because yeah, I think it's going to be a doozy. All right, I've made it. So that part went well. That was really easy to find, actually. So Google Maps, just Google Map it. It'll take you straight there. No problem. Oh my God, look at that. That is fantastic. Yeah, so all the stuff that I heard online is true. Score one for this place. I mean, that is on par, in my opinion, with the Petrified Forest and the Painted Desert stuff that I've seen today in that park. This definitely lives up to that, in my opinion. That is something. It is also a very long way down. It'd be so cool to just go hike down there. I wonder if that's prohibited or if you can do that. I apologize for any audio issues because, yeah, it's windy, very breezy. We're up here on the edge of this, canyon. It's always very windy in this region of Arizona every time I come here. So it's really hard to film in these places and get really good audio. So hopefully it comes out okay. Wow. So I probably still have about 15, 20 minutes, maybe more, before the sun goes down. And my hope is that it's gonna come below those clouds out there and then really illuminate the scene. So hopefully we're in for a good show. But while we're waiting, let's go check this place out. It's kind of funky and weird. So over here you've got these little picnic areas, but they're very overgrown. A couple grills. I'm almost afraid to walk in here. Probably broken glass, snakes, who knows what. I mean, this isn't horrible. And I definitely don't think this is being maintained by anybody. People just litter here too. I mean, there's really no trash cans or anywhere to discard of your waste. I guess they're just banana peels, but I've heard there's a lot of broken glass. I see a lot of beer cans. So people are disrespectful. That's just how people are. but yeah, I saw a lot of beer cans or a couple over there on the edge too. So at least people could be cool, you know? Best of all, right now, I am the only person here. There's not a single person in sight. I see people driving out on Route 87 out there. Who knows, we may get another person or two. We'll see. There's probably a good chance we won't. And to get a sunset opportunity like this with nobody here other than myself, that is the ideal circumstance. Yeah, this is really cool. You know what else I realized? You can see right over there, that's the San Francisco peaks of Flagstaff. Even though we're probably about 70 miles away from that, it's huge on the landscape. It's covered in clouds right now, but that is amazing too. You get it all at this spot. And an almost full moon to boot. Couldn't ask for better circumstances. Well, I guess you could. If it was less windy, then it'd be perfect. So clearly this was worthy of a park at some point. I mean, with an overlook like that, how could it not be? I'm just guessing for budgetary reasons or something. The county or whoever, it is a county park, they just couldn't afford to maintain it, which is a shame. It'd almost be better if they just ripped out like this stuff in the bathroom and just got rid of it. Maybe that would help cut down on the litter and grossness factor. But yeah, you've got some graffiti here. And this was completed in 1981, it says. Should I even peek in here? I'm afraid to. Dun dun dun, oh, that's disgusting. Full of trash. There's an old vault toilet in there. That's pretty gross. I don't want to gross you guys out. But at least there's nobody passed out in there. That's what I was really wondering. Is it just me, or do you guys have a hard time reading graffiti letters? If I study it enough, I might be able to. Does it say loan? L-O-N-E? Or what does it say? Or love? I'm sorry, L-O-V-E. I'm guessing that says love. What do you guys think? I don't know what that was in there. Part of the bathroom, I guess. Rez. Hopefully there's no bad language here, because this is a family-friendly channel. So if I miss something, I sincerely apologize. I don't want to get in trouble with YouTube either. And that one, I believe, says chief. It's weird. I can't really make it out when I look at it with my own eyes, but when I look at it with my camera through the viewfinder, it pops. In the interest of fair reporting, I did see some gross stuff in a couple places. It looked like human excrement, probably. Just like, my God, people. Like, what are people thinking? So yeah, if you come here, you don't need to go check out the restrooms. Just keep your sights on the beauty out here. You can kind of walk out here. I want to be careful though, because it does drop off steeply. And this is dirt, it's not like rock, so the grip is questionable over here. Well, I guess it's not a straight drop down, but it's pretty steep. This may not be the smartest thing either that I'm doing, but yeah, look at the color. You probably could make your way down there slowly and get down there pretty easily, I imagine. I haven't seen any signs or any restrictions for doing it. I'm certainly not doing it now, but I'm wondering though, that would be quite an adventure just to go down there and walk through those badlands. Thinking right over here, I think my plan worked, sweet. So the sun's coming down behind those clouds, it should illuminate this pretty nicely, I'm thinking. Oh my God, it is so windy. It's just getting worse and worse as the sun goes down. Man. Get a couple last looks in here. My low light camera's kind of lighting up still. It's a lot darker than the camera makes it look, but it looks pretty on the camera from what I can see. All right, I'm back in the car. Had to get out of that wind. Just wanted to say a few words about this. Yeah, I mean, the park is run down and gross. There's no doubt about that. Just ignore that, though. Keep your sights focused out there. The view of the Painted Desert here, it's almost just as good as what I've seen at in other places in national parks. It's amazing. So that more than lived up to what I thought, exceeded my expectations. The sunset itself, I've seen a lot better. I just think it's the luck of the draw. There were a lot of clouds out today, made the lighting kind of weird. It was still beautiful. But the wind, oh boy, is the wind brutal out here. I have a question for any of you that live in Northeast Arizona, out in these like plains and this open desert. Is there ever not wind? Like seriously, every time I've been out here, there's wind. So there's actually a car coming down the road now too. So I'm gonna head on out in case it's the cops. I don't think I'm trespassing though. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And check us out on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I better watch where I'm driving on this road. Bump, bump, bump.